today? Any exciting news?
No, Miss Emmons. Just like every other day.
Evie, now don't you go telling him about the movies.
Stop it, Beth. You know you always have to be the first to tell.
We're taking Mrs. Hemmings to the movies tonight to see Marlon Brando in A Streetcar Named Desire. You want to come along?
Well, no. That's why I spent the money on the TV, so I wouldn't have to go out. I'm not sure I'll allow you girls to go see it. I hear it's kind of risque.
But it's Tennessee Williams, Mr. Hemmings.
Hollywood. They'll find a way to turn it all around and put a lot of sex into it.
Well, the whole play's about sex. I don't see how they could put any more in it.
All I know is that Marlon Brando is the handsomest man in the whole world. And I'd go any place to see him, especially in a sexy part.
Well, I don't know. You girls going to see a sexy movie.
Come on, Mr. Hemmings, we're old enough.
Don't bully my girls, Gilbert. We're going to see Marlon Brando and Vivian Leigh, and you can just sit here all you want. Come on, Evie.
Good night, Mr. Hemmings.
Good night, Evie.
You think that Vivian Leigh really fell in love with Clark Gable?
Now, there was a picture.
It wasn't.
Oh, I couldn't bear the sad ending.
I predict the Streetcar Named Desire will garner her another Oscar.
Mildred, will you stop about Vivian Leigh? Marlon Brando, there's a hunk. Do you see his body?
Why, I thought he was coarse.
Well, of course he's coarse. He's supposed to be coarse. But I tell you one thing, he can put his shoes under my bed anytime.
Oh!
Am I right or am I right?
He's an excellent actor.
Actor? Talking about his
sex.
What'd I say? I think you've lost your sense of humor.
Sorry, Beth, I didn't sleep too well last night.
Good morning,
Biddy. Good morning, Mr. Hadmire.
The crust of ash which formed the top layer of the tomb preserved Pompeii from change by man or nature. As centuries passed, the ancient city was forgotten. Until 1718, when a peasant found traces of the old city in his vineyard.
Didn't they know it was there?
Oh, no. It was a lost city for ages and ages. And here, you can see some of the plaster casts of the people who died during the Holocaust.
That one sort of looks like Alan.
Here is an inscription that you would probably see on a public building. And it's our Latin phrase for today. Salus populi nex suprema est.
What does that mean?
Alan?
The healthy people are the most supreme?
Close. It's a very wise saying, and it means the welfare of the people is the supreme law. When I took my trip to Italy last year, I saw Mount Vesuvius. It was just as the sun was setting. And it was the most beautiful sight I've ever seen. Assembly.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. Y'all be seated, please. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. As you know, this is our last assembly program before the start of our Thanksgiving vacation. Know how sad you all are about that. We have a very special treat this morning. Mrs. Henry Blood, chairman of the music department, has arranged a program of musical selections to be performed by some of our most gifted pupils.
Will be played by Billy Calvin. He will perform the Adagio in B minor by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
TV?
Yes?
Are you all right?
I'm too sick to go to school today. Would you please ask Mr. Havermeyer if he could get the substitute teacher?
Why, sure. Hope you feel better. See you later, kid.
Could I speak to Dr. Neal, please? Evelyn Wyckoff. Well, then, could I have an appointment as soon as possible? I just need some professional advice. 4:30? Yes, that will be fine. Thank you.
Thank you. who were classmates together. I remember you were a fine basketball player and track.
Oh, yes, I was quite an athlete back then. Actually, I probably lost out on a great deal playing that game. I might have been a surgeon at the Mayo Clinic by now if I hadn't played so much basketball. Have you ever been in love, Miss Wyckoff? Now, please don't think I'm one of those doctors who tells his patients that the way to solve their problems is to have romance. But nature wanted us to use our bodies. If we don't, they dry up and function poorly. It must be very difficult being an unmarried teacher in freedom. You have so little privacy.
I think an affair would help me. That's what you're trying to tell me, isn't it, Doctor? I can't believe that these terrible depressions I've been feeling could be cured by a romance.
I'd like you to see a psychiatrist in Wichita. A Dr. Steiner. He's a good man, take my word for it. Came out from the East a few years ago. He's Jewish. We have no antagonism toward Jews, I hope.
I've no racial prejudice at all. I fought at the school for total integration.
Right, here's his name and address. I'll advise him that you'll give him a call.
Is it terribly expensive?
Oh, I'm sure he'll work something out with your budget.
I hope so.
Right, this is a prescription for Secanol. To let you get some sleep. Also, I'm going to give you one for hormone pills.
Why, are you giving me hormone pills? What's wrong with me?
I believe you may be going through a premature menopause. Now, I could be wrong. We'll get the laboratory results back in a few days, and it'll confirm it one way or the other. Meanwhile, I want you to take these hormone pills to bring you around again.
Neil, I'm only 35.
That's why I said premature.
I hope it can be averted.
Well, it can be averted. It's up to you. And Dr. Steiner can help.
Thank you, Doctor.
Has anyone ever told you that you're a very attractive young woman?
This is real good spaghetti. Isn't it good, Emily?
It's not bad at all.
I just love your silver.
We lost our silver during the war.
Oh.
World War II?
No, the Civil War, darling.
I knew it. The Yankees came to our plantation and just destroyed everything.
You must have been a very young girl.
And my grandmother, she told me this lieutenant killed every single little chicken with his soul.
Terrible.
You know Louise Dorfmeyer? She can't even eat chicken.
They have a lovely home. Everything antique. Just gorgeous. A little plain, maybe.
Back home, there was a hardware store run by old man Blacker. When he died, they opened up his safe and found $200,000 in cash.
Ooh, hot. There's nothing that goes with spaghetti like red wine. Drink to that.
Okay, Miss Wyckoff, I'll see you about it tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, Les.
Bye-bye.
Evelyn, come on, you've got 20 minutes to make that bus. Don't be late. Come on.
Here.
You can pin it on in the car. Come on.
So, I will. Oh, Ray, don't wash that part of the board.
There you go. Okay. On board. Thank you.
Hello.
Watch your step. Watch your step. Watch your step. So long, Red.
Miss Wyckoff. Seem to be hurting an awful lot.
Yes. It happens all the time. I thought it would pass, but it hasn't. I can't function anymore.
What'd you do to your hands?
I was at a party, and everybody was having a great time, and there was this mirror. I was drawn towards it, and
what did you see in the mirror?
Myself.
Did you look like you?
Yes. Yes, and no. I don't know.
You didn't like what you saw?
No. I wanted to smash it. I wanted to smash everything.
Maybe you've disliked yourself for a very long time. Is that possible?
Yes. And it's gotten worse. It's not only myself. It's my work. It's everything. Everything seems pointless. I don't want to do anything.
I don't want to get up in the morning. And when I do, even the sunshine looks idiotic.
I understand you've missed a couple of periods. Is that so?
Yes.
Do you think you're pregnant?
No. No, I couldn't possibly be. I'm not married.
How about your boyfriend? Couldn't he be responsible?
I don't have a boyfriend.
Do you ever have sex? You seem to find it difficult to respond to that one. Has it been a very long time since you were with a man, sexually? Have you ever been with a man?
I think he's a queer, if you ask me.
Nobody did. I know John Kingston. He bragged that he passed his modern European history course by sitting in the front row with his legs sprawled, wide apart. You know, in case Chester Rollins wanted to make use of them. Boys do that in my class all the time. They don't mean anything by it. Besides, my kid brother did that.
Your kid brother wasn't assigned homework requiring the reading of communist literature, was he?
Of course not. What's that got to do with anything?
Well, Chester Rollins is teaching commie propaganda to the students in this school, and I think it's un-American.
Commie propaganda?
Yes. Marx, Karl Marx, the communist.
Well, I don't see how you can teach a course in modern history without reading Karl Marx.
Oh, really?
Well, his philosophy completely changed the destiny of Russia and China. More than half the world. I don't see how you can ignore Karl Marx.
Well, you don't have to assign reading matter that he wrote. It's communistic. It did cause revolution.
Well, if we're all going to understand Russia and China, right or wrong, the least we could do is to read the sources of their political beliefs. Suppose we forbade our students to read Thomas Jefferson.
What's the matter with her?
Nothing. She just thinks she's right.
I do, too.
Well, I heard she was going to Wichita to a psychiatrist. I heard she was doing it because of the change.
What's wrong with going to a psychiatrist? A lot of famous people go to psychiatrists.
Well, I hope he does her some good. I didn't have a moment's problem with the change.
Poor Evie. I'm just afraid she's going to get in trouble talking about things like that.
About communism?
Yes. Yeah.
Senator McCarthy has revealed a lot about fellow travelers in the university. But they can be in high school, too, you know.
Listen here, Red. I begin to think you got yourself a boyfriend over here in Wichita. You gotta tell him that all the money you spent on these bus tickets, you could buy yourself a wedding ring. Listen, none of your kids are red. Tell you the truth, I don't think I can make this trip without you.
Do you miss your mother and father?
Miss my father. He's a warm, generous man. But my parents didn't get along too well together. In fact, they always started fighting. It was always the same. Sooner or later, they'd start to fight, and I was always frightened.
Of
the fighting.
Doing they yell at each other, or did they get physical?
Both. I used to hide in the closet so that I couldn't see what was going on, but I could hear it. I thought they would kill each other.
Did you think someone might kill you?
Yes, I stood up for my father once. I thought my mother would want to kill me.
You think she wanted to kill your father?
Well, there was this time when He had a cut on his head and he was bleeding. And I went to help him to wipe his head, and he was just standing there with no clothes on. And my mother was screaming at him. Then she pointed at him and said, all he ever wanted to do was to do it. Then she grabbed me and threw me out of the room. And she said, I'd grow up to be the same.
The same as her or the same as your father?
I don't know, but just the same.
How old were you then?
8.
How old were you when you had your first period?
11.
What was your reaction when you first started to menstruate?
I was very pleased. But I didn't tell my mother.
Was that pleasing?
Yes.
What else pleased you?
Going to the movies. I used to go a lot. I used to fall in love with the movie stars. I used to go alone. I like being alone. And I love my work. After all, it's been my whole life. It's better not to need anybody. It's better to be self-sufficient and to be free of all that.
But that's not good enough anymore. You haven't got a husband, a lover, children?
I thought of children. If this menopause is true, then it's all over.
Maybe it isn't all over. Your life is more important than shadows on a screen. I think it's a good place for us to end the session.
How long is your Christmas vacation?
12 days.
We've got into some pretty serious things right now. I think we should continue to go into them deeply. We ought to see each other as often as possible during your vacation, and then we can decide what's going to happen next.
Yes, Mother, I know. I wrote you the letter so that you wouldn't be upset. Hiding what, Mother? No, I don't have a sweetheart. I'm sorry, Mother. I'd love to come home if I could, but I have this work to do. Yes, Mother. I'll call you Christmas morning.
Evelyn!
Now, if you get lonesome, you'll come, you promise. Don't worry about me, Beth. I'll be fine. Mr. Hemming?
Yes, Merry Christmas, Beth, darling.
Merry Christmas.
Have a good time.
Oh, thank you. Merry Christmas. Now, you come. Merry Christmas, Beth. Merry Christmas, honey.
Evie, come in here with us.
Thanks, Mrs. Hemmings. But I really have to work. I have a lot of thank you notes to write.
Just step.
Got something good for you.
listen, I just had a great thought. Why don't you and me have a cup of coffee together?
I'm sorry, I can't. I have an appointment.
Hey. All right, come on, whoever he is. Now, he's going to wait a few minutes for you, will he? Huh? Will he? Sure he will. Come on, what do you say?
Will I?
Huh? Hmm? Really? Just one.
All right.
Well, see how easy that was? Cups of coffee. What's your first name, Red?
Evelyn. Evelyn Wyckoff.
You don't mind that I call you Red, do you?
No, I rather like it. No one else ever has.
You mean to tell me that nobody ever teased you about all that red hair when you were a kid?
Yes, but that was a long time ago.
You're a nice girl, Red.
I'm really no girl.
Well, you are to me.
Thanks, Ed.
You're welcome, Red. Red Ned sounds like a comedy team, doesn't it?
Yes.
There you go. Thank you. A little cream. Sorry about the wife, Red.
Oh, please don't be. It's perfectly natural you should have a wife. I wasn't surprised. You mustn't apologize.
I apologize because I like you. Because I like you, I think you got a right to know just how it is.
I understand how it is.
How about you? You got a husband?
No, I'm not married.
You're a mighty fine piece of woman to be living without a husband. Some guys don't know what they're missing. Hey, something else, too, Ed. Some of us guys got married when we were young to some hot-looking broad just because she was sexy. I see, as the time goes by, you find out that, well, there's a lot of other things that a woman can be besides just being sexy. And they're a lot more important over the long haul.
What other things might a woman be, Ed?
You just take a look in the mirror someday. Take a good look at you. You see what I mean?
That's one of the most beautiful things anyone ever said to me.
Listen, Red, I'm going to level with you. I'm not always faithful to the wife. I can show you a real good time here some night. I never had a first-class woman like you. How about it?
I just couldn't, Ed. You're married. I wouldn't feel right.
Oh, hell. You take your fun where you can find it. That's my motto.
I just couldn't.
Well, when you change your mind, you just give me a little wink in that mirror of mine, okay? And I'll show you a real good time. I guarantee it.
Take him up on it. Because he's only a bus driver? Because he's married? Or because I'm afraid? Now you're going to put your head to one side and look at me and say, why are you afraid, Miss Wyckoff?
Maybe we should change places.
Dr. Steiner, I'm afraid I wouldn't be what he expects in bed. A woman my age with no experience, maybe you'd be disillusioned.
I think you're expecting me to give you permission to have an affair with the bus driver.
Of course not. But I suspect you might be pleased if I did.
You want someone to tell you to go ahead and do this thing you're so frightened of.
But why?
First, you'd be relieved of guilt. And if it should turn out to be an unhappy romance, you'd have someone to blame. Someone else besides yourself. Being alive is learning how to make decisions. Your own decisions. decisions without persecuting yourself by worrying about what other people will think about you. People will do anything to avoid humiliation and shame. It's very frightening when new and powerful emotions are being born, and you are experiencing a rebirth.
Sometimes it takes a long time, doesn't it?
Some people never make it.
Going to be a wonderful new year.
Sure.
I'll drink to that.
Oh, me too.
Oh, Evie, it's such a pleasure to see you like this.
Like what, Marie?
Oh, like your old self.
God, Evie, you know the last time when you were here, when you smashed your hands into the mirror? I was very scared.
Oh, I was just going through a bad time. Things are different now. It's a new year, new resolutions.
Wichita.
Is Ed on the other route today?
Nah, he quit. Left town. Left his pretty little wife, too.
He was gone. Left town. I decided to take him up on his offer, and I was going to spend the night with him.
I seem to see a smile. Are you pleased with yourself?
Well, I'm not exactly happy, but it was the first time I'd ever... I liked him, and I know he liked me.
And I think you're liking yourself a little bit more than when you first came to see me.
Well... I can't understand why I'm not crying now that he's gone. I even bought some new clothes.
What sort of clothes?
Pretty lingerie.
That's not just clothes.
I really splurged. They were so luxurious. I couldn't afford them.
Maybe you couldn't afford not to afford them.
They are demanding that I fire Chester Rollins. They're saying he is soft on communism, calling him a red. Really, it's an awful mess. Here, look. Even the Standard has come out with an editorial criticizing the school's educational policy, hinting at un-Americanism in the Freedom High School faculty. I am forced to fire him.
I think that's a mistake. In fact, I know it is. What if I'd done the same thing? There's plenty of Latin that's earth-shattering too, Mr. Habermeyer.
Miss Wyckoff, you have been here for 10 years. You are a respected teacher. Your reputation is impeccable. Chester, on the other hand. Well, I don't spend a lot of time listening to idle gossip, but there are certain rumors. I mean, public opinion is against him.
His personal life is not the issue. How can we teach about freedom if...
Look, it's very unfortunate, but I am only a public servant. What can I do?
Well, maybe we could arrange a meeting with the PTA and explain to them why we can't do it.
And who's going to do the explaining?
We of the Midwest, with all our faults, all our isolationism, our indifference to political and social conflict, we are America, the backbone of America. To forbid the studying of a political philosophy like that of Karl Marx, which differs from ours, is to imitate the communists in countries where education is a farce. As another philosopher, Edmund Burke, said, the only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing. And good people of freedom. If we permit men like Joe McCarthy to bully us into firing Mr. Rawlins for assigning the reading of Karl Marx, we are un-American, imitating communists, fascists, and totalitarians. For only we are the guardians of the precious freedom we have in America.
And don't forget, 8:30 at the Chinese restaurant.
See you.
Okay,
congratulations.
Thanks.
You were mighty convincing.
Thanks a lot. I didn't see you tonight. Where were you? Were you there?
Yes. But I hid. I hid. I was so terrified. I thought they were going to tar and feather me and run me out of town on a rail.
Oh, come on, Chester.
Emily, don't think it can't happen here. It wouldn't be the first time. Of course, I want to thank you. But Evelyn, you can't imagine what it feels like. That hatred. I've never felt so alone before. I didn't know that it could happen to me.
Don't. Chester, please, don't. You're a fine teacher. You've done nothing wrong.
Yes, but what's going to become of me? Do you think they'll throw me out? They're saying so many terrible things about me.
Chester, don't. Don't. Please, Chester. You know, if we keep this up, they'll be saying something else terrible about you and me. Come on. Walk me as far as my house.
One of my own girls, Gilbert.
Mm-hmm.
What if we were harboring a communist right here in this house? I wouldn't want that, even if it was Evie.
Evie? A communist? Lala, what have you been drinking?
Just the same, I think we ought to watch her.
What do you expect to see? That's silly, Mrs. Hemming.
Evie, come on in. Mrs. Hemmings here thinks you're a pinko. Show us your card, kid.
Well,
I might as well tell you the truth.
I've fallen in love with Chester. But he won't have me.
Chester.
I beg your pardon, Miss Wyckoff. Didn't mean to disturb you with my vocalizing.
No, no, you're not disturbing me. You have a good voice.
Haven't seen you around in quite a while, Miss Wyckoff. Been busy?
Very busy.
You mind?
No, go right ahead.
Must be kind of lonesome for you school teachers, huh?
What do you mean, Rafe?
Well, I don't know. Seems to me none of you gets much fun out of life.
Oh, I just manage all right.
Folks tell me you've done a lot of good for the Negro students here. You got them the right to eat equal in the cafeteria.
Yes, that's right, I did.
Wonder how many of you white people really mean it when you pretend to care about us Negroes.
Rafe, you'd better leave here at once. I'll have to speak to Mr. Havemeyer.
What's the matter, Miss Wyckoff? I say something wrong?
No, you didn't say anything wrong. I know you're on scholarship at the junior college. You'd better be careful.
Problems?
No, I just wanted to talk to you. I was... Well, it's nothing, really. I was just worried about old man Bose. Oh. He used to clean the classroom. He was the janitor. I wonder why he isn't here anymore. Is he sick or something?
Gallbladder. Don't worry, he'll be back. He's all right. Probably, sometime before these scholarship athletes have to start training for track, anyway.
Well, when will that be?
Well, I don't know. Evelyn, you don't look well. Are you taking care of yourself? I wouldn't want you to have a relapse.
Oh, I'm just fine, Mr. Havemeyer. Just fine.
Now, remember, this is just a practice test, and it will just show us if you need any extra help. And if you do, sign up for tutoring, and I'll help you prepare for the final. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Rafe, when are you going out for track this year?
I ain't.
Oh, why not?
Ligament.
Oh, you tore a ligament.
That's what the doctor says.
I'm sorry.
I ain't. I only like football.
Oh,
It's swollen. Want to feel? Feel that swell in there?
Yes.
You can feel it better here. Let me show you. That's beginning to swell, too.
Let go of my hand, Rafe. Let go of it!
I'm warning you. Not one sound. Relax, Miss Lockhart. I'm gonna get inside that tight place. I know you're gonna like it. You're gonna want this thing of mine every time you can.
No.
Yes, you will, baby. Yes, you will. Relax, baby.
No!
Just a little at first. You just relax. It's gonna go in nice and easy. Then you're gonna love it. Now relax! Damn it. When I'm ready.
No, my father. Stop. 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 Please, stop. Stop.
Thank you.
Dr. Steiner, please. Where is he? Why didn't you tell me? What emergency? Are you sure you can't get him? Well, how long will he be gone? No, no. I don't want to talk to another doctor.
Evelyn, you're very late. Whatever kept you?
Otis, Kathy. Very good. Today, we're going to start a new unit on Cicero. As you know, Cicero changed the course of the Roman Empire. Tracy, I can see you did your homework. Tomorrow, we'll work on past pluperfect subjunctive.
Where was you yesterday?
I went shopping with some friends.
After this, you be here. Understand?
That sounds like an order.
What's the matter, Miss Wyckoff? Didn't I, have enough to give you?
What happened last Friday will never happen again.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going home, Rafe.
What's the matter, Miss Wyckoff? I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't.
You must let me leave, Rafe. You must let me go.
Just relax, Miss Wyckoff. I'm not going to hurt you again.
Rafe.
I just want to hold you close.
Don't you realize how dangerous this is?
I just want to hold you.
Rafe, just please let me go, Rafe. Rafe, stop this. Stop it.
Ray, stop it. Stop it.
Hello, Beth.
Oh, Evie, I've been looking all over for you. We're all going to go have Chinese food and then take in the 7:15 show. You want to come along?
Not tonight, thank you, Beth.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
She borrowed a book of mine. You haven't seen one lying around with my name on it, have you?
No, ma'am.
Well, I'll just take a look. Do you mind having to work while being on scholarship?
Well, it is hard to do your studying and train for football and clean up the rooms.
You boys don't like the one they call Rafe, do you? The boy who cleans my classroom.
He's no boy. He's a man.
What do you mean?
Well, Coach Simmons found him in a pool hall in Oklahoma City, hustling for a living. I bet he's about 24 years old. Thinks he's God's gift to the football team, royal lord of the jungle or something.
Does he sleep in the dormitory?
They threw him out because he wouldn't bunk with no one.
Anyone. Wouldn't bunk with anyone.
Yeah, well, it's a powerful back. Makes a lot of touchdowns. But that don't matter to me, because I don't tolerate nothing from nobody.
If he doesn't live in the dorm, where does he live?
Probably sleeps in the boarding house. I heard he spent some time in a home for juvenile delinquents.
Well, it doesn't seem to be here.
Hello, Rafe.
You like what I gave you yesterday? You liked it, didn't you? You want it again? Well, now, come on over and get it. Come on, Miss Wyckoff. Don't let nothing like this go to waste. You better come get it while you can. I see you beg a little, Miss Wyckoff.
What do you mean, Rafe?
I'd like to see you crawl over here on your hands and knees and beg.
I could never do such a degrading thing.
Yes, you could. Come on now, let's see you. Down on your knees. Beg. Junior here wants a little attention. Now, if you ain't nice to Junior, his daddy's like to get mad. Move! Now, come to me. Move! That's right. Come on. You was doing just fine.
I've been quiet lately. It's all your fault that we have him here. But you don't look too happy about it.
How can you say that, Beth?
See that one over there washing the dishes? Now, he's the kind that makes everybody hate niggers. Beth, that's what he is, an uppity nigger. Where I come from, we tell the truth. And truth be told, I don't like that arrogant kid. You can't pretend you like him either. He sweeps the floor in my classroom, and he looks at me like I'm the dirt. And believe me, I return the favor.
Racial prejudice is one of man's most difficult problems to solve during his time here on Earth. Perhaps God intended it to be that way. And if we don't solve it, Beth, we're all going to be destroyed.
You sure do get fired up, don't you? What do you want to do for dinner tonight? I'm so sick of Chinese food, I could puke.
Calling so early on Saturday. Hello. Oh, yes, just a moment. It's for you, Evie.
You never to call me here. But I can't meet you. All right.
Do you have any idea who that man might be that keeps calling? Does she have a gentleman friend, Beth?
No, Mrs. Emmett.
I hate to say this, but that man's voice sounds like a Negro.
Really?
I told myself at first that it was just one of her Negro students calling about schoolwork. Well, I suppose there's some logical explanation.
What if I told some of the other guys on the team what a good piece of ass you are, Miss Wyckoff? School board wouldn't waste no time getting rid of you. They find out about us, would they?
Why do you want to harm me?
I don't know.
Rafe, promise me. Promise me you'll never tell anybody what's happened here between us.
Sure. I promise.
You don't care what happens, really, do you? Look, if nothing else, at least we could have respect for each other. You don't respect anybody, do you?
Yeah. Me.
Evie, I almost forgot. A Dr. Steiner called from Wichita. He wants you to call him.
Thank you, Mrs. Hemmings.
Evie.
Told them what a good piece of ass you are, Miss Wyckoff. They say they won't tell if you give them some, too. I was just teasing you, little Miss Wyckoff. I wouldn't tell those dummies nothing about you, baby. You're all mine. I'm keeping it that way. They'd be jealous if they knew what a good lady you're getting to be. Besides, a good-looking nigga like me ain't got a truck with those fools. Now, baby, I'm ready to take care of you.
Hey, what if Miss Wyckoff is putting out for that jigaboo?
Of course she is. What else he'd be doing in that room till all hours?
Shit, I can't believe it. I had her for 4 years and left.
Well, you didn't have her the way he's having her. A nigger. Jesus. I never heard of any white woman doing with a nigger before.
I heard she's going to some psychiatrist.
Guess she must be crazy or something.
He's not bad looking for a nigger.
Just the same. I got my private opinion of any white woman do a thing like that.
We don't know for sure that's what's going on. You can't condemn a person without a trial.
As far as I'm concerned, just being in the same room with that jigaboo's guilty. I'd stay out of it if I was you.
Rafe! No!
Ah! 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 Ah!
bastard.
I'm Mrs. Brewster. Mr. Habermeyer called me this morning and said you'd be unable to handle your class today. He'd like to see you in the office as soon as possible.
Yes, I see. Here is the roll book. The first assignment for today was to read and translate pages 5 through 8 of the first Catalinian oration. I'll leave you my geranium, Mrs. Brewster.
I promise to take good care of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please sit down. You know, in all my years of experience, I don't think I've ever been in a position that I've hated as much as I hate this one. Nor have I ever been more at a loss to understand if the reports that I've heard are true.
They're true, Mr. Havemeyer.
Well, I think I've had enough psychology to understand that there must be some reasonable explanation, either emotional or psychological, for what you've done, if you want to tell me about it.
Mr. Havemeyer, I think the reasons are unimportant now.
I mean, I have always felt that teachers needed more emotional outlets. Goodness knows that some of the normal pastimes and recreations that others enjoy so freely are denied us. I enjoy a drink now and then, but I would never allow myself to be caught with a glass in my hand. Obviously, measures will be taken against this Negro, Rafe.
I wouldn't want to see him lose his opportunity for an education.
It's in the junior college board's hands now. Certainly the football fans would be upset if they kicked him out.
But they mustn't.
Well, between you and me, I think that the next time he scores a touchdown, whatever he's done will be forgotten. The resentment against you is much stronger. I've already received some very threatening phone calls about you. It's ironic, isn't it? A man never suffers the same social ostracism that a woman does in situations like this.
That's true.
Well, you must realize that the pressure is on me to you know, you are probably the finest teacher that I have ever had the pleasure of working with. But I have to ask you to resign as of now.
I understand.
I mean that I think you should plan on leaving now.
I know.
Well, is there anything I can do for you?
Well, it would help if you could possibly give me a recommendation. I realize what I'm asking. But maybe in some place far away. I feel certain I could live up to any recommendation you can give me.
It's all right. There was a young man that I went to school with when I was getting my master's degree. A very bright fellow. He's now superintendent of schools someplace in New Jersey. He's a good fellow, and he's broad-minded. I would have to tell him that I asked you to resign and give him some truthful explanation. But at the same time, I could still give him a very, very good recommendation for you as a teacher. You know, I, for one, believe that this behavior pattern, the lapse in it is over, that it won't recur.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, I guess this is goodbye.
Yes. Yes. Goodbye.
Evelyn, why on earth did you do that?
Mr. Havemeyer, you've been very kind.
Good luck, Miss Wyckoff.
Leaving today for a long trip, and I don't sleep well on trains. Last year when I went to Italy, I didn't sleep at all. Could you... I need something to help me sleep.
So you're asking me for sleeping pills?
Yes, that's it. I need something strong to help me through this.
Of course, I'll give you a prescription. Naturally, I heard what happened. I wasn't suggesting any such thing, you know. I was encouraging you to find a gentleman friend. I never had the slightest intention that you... Well, I hope you don't think that I was suggesting anything quite like that.
Dr. Neal, will you give me a prescription for sleeping pills?
Of course I will. I'm very sorry about what happened. Must be very... I'll call the pharmacy. I hope you have a pleasant trip.
Thank you.
cab to 1230 Meadows Lane. Right away. Thank you.
Beth. Are you leaving already?
The sooner the better, I should think, wouldn't you?
Well, I didn't. Yes, I guess you're right. Is Mrs. Hemmings at home?
I think she's in her room. She didn't come down when I came.
Are you going to go?
I don't know.
Why in heaven's name did you do it? I feel like... you were my best friend. And now I feel like I hardly knew you at all. Why didn't you talk to me? Maybe I could have helped you.
Beth, please. What happened to me was inevitable. I wouldn't change it. And I feel no shame for what I did.
Good luck, Evelyn.
I'll take these. My things are upstairs.
Good luck.